Hey, welcome to Half the Battle. It's once again time to go back. Back to the future. All the way to the year 2000.
Battle Force 2000.
Huh, you know, I got a feeling that we've done this thing before.
Today, we're talking about Blocker, Battle Force 2000's Eliminator driver. His only figure was released in 1987, with all original body parts. And I have to be honest here, this is one of those toys where it's very difficult for me to do a review. You see, it's not bad, but it's not that good either. There's nothing really exceptional that grabs my attention, positively or negatively. As far as the figure itself goes, that's not a terrible thing, really. It's nice enough looking, and I'd say it deserves to be in your collection. He has some nice detailing. I'm just a bit puzzled why there's a camo pattern on his legs and helmet, but not on his torso. Once again, like all of Battle Force 2000, he only has one accessory, his gun. It's weird and futuristic looking. It's part of the course, too, when it comes to Battle Force 2000. It does have a strap attached, and if nothing else, it'll keep the thing from falling and disappearing down your couch. There's a little bit of weirdness online that I found when it comes to this figure. It seems that his camo pattern, which is brown, is considered to be orange. I can assure all of you, it is not orange, it is brown.
And how do I know this? Well, because my eye sockets don't spontaneously fill up with blood when I look at the thing.
I can be brief about the vehicle he's supposed to drive, the Eliminator. It's a slightly futuristic-looking Jeep with a detachable gun station. Nothing that hasn't been done better. It's pretty meh.
There is one thing that makes this guy special, though. He's got a variation.
For those of you who don't know, sometimes in the middle of a production run of a particular toy, the manufacturer will make a change to the toy for whatever reason. Starting in the late 90s, companies started to deliberately do this to either delight, antagonize, or confuse collectors, depending on who you ask. McFarlane, I'm looking at you here. But in the 80s, it was mostly done to make toys more appealing or safer. In this case, some versions of Blocker came with a visor attached to his head, as well as a slightly different color scheme. My best guess is that this was done to make the toy more appealing, as it does look cooler this way.
Yeah, by the way, I had to grab that picture off eBay. I don't actually have the variation.
In Europe, there was yet another variation, but it's just a packaging one this time. Here's a carded Blocker from Europe. Do you notice anything? There's no mention of Battle Force 2000. In fact, all of the Battle Force 2000 guys were released as just regular members of the Joe team. Kinda weird.
Now let's see what we can learn from his file card.
Well, basically, Blocker is a really, really good driver. Even though he doesn't come with a vehicle. Yes, I will bitch about this every single bloody time a member of Battle Force 2000 comes up. They're vehicle drivers that don't come with vehicles. That's like having Knight Rider without a car. If you do that, you're basically stuck with David Hasselhoff pretending to be relevant. Wait, why the hell am I talking about David Hasselhoff? Look, let's get back to the toy, shall we? Blocker learned his driving skills while being a taxi driver in Boston. After several armed robberies and a serious accident, he realized that he'd really prefer to drive something armored that could shoot back. Can't say I blame him, really.
Unfortunately, it does mean that this was the first thing that came into my head when I looked at the file card.
You talking to me? You talking to me?
Yeah, Blocker, buddy, friendly word of advice here. Jodie Foster ain't gonna care. Since we're talking about Battle Force 2000, at this point I could just use my own stock footage to tell you that they didn't appear in the cartoons, so neither did Blocker. So no cartoon section this week. Speaking of stock footage, as far as the comic goes, well, we're gonna have to go back to issue 68. Again. An issue I've shown you so much that it's beginning to get wear and tear. In this issue that marks the debut of Battle Force 2000, Blocker is Blaster's friend, and the one that first makes Blaster notice that something is up when he starts going all cranky. And that's basically all Blocker does that issue. He does show up in the incredible Cobra Civil War story arc, though. One of the best-loved, most awesome stories ever told in the comic.
And here's Blocker's contribution to it. There, were you impressed and satisfied?
Yes, that's right. Just one shot, in the background, not in color. In one of the most important story arcs ever. Great showing, dude. Great showing. And finally, we get to the reason why there's only one toy of this guy. You see, he gets killed but good in the Battle of Benzene with most of his buddies. In conclusion, his one and only figure is fine if unremarkable. And the same can be said about his comic appearances. And the vehicle he's supposed to drive. Yeah, unremarkable, but fine. This episode isn't gonna be making the highlights reel.
Hey, I should have a highlight reel someday. Gonna need to have some actual highlights first, though. Oh well. See you next week, everybody!
In this case, some versions of Blocker came with a Viver. Viver is Dutch for a pond, by the way.